In this video, we will show you how to create a tabs component in WeWeb. We'll be using component properties, also called props, variables, and workflows. It will look something like this. So we will be able to give our component a collection, any collection, and then automatically when we click on an item, it will display the description of the item we selected. So here we have the same component, but twice. So two instances of the same component. One where we bound our collection of fruits, which we have here, and one where we bound our collection of treats, which we have here. So both instances of the component work the same way because it is the same component. Now let's try building this from scratch. Here in a blank project, I will add a container that I'll call tabs. And my tabs will have a heading. It will also have another container with my list of items. So my items, and in there I will want to display a text element. So the name, so the title, for example, of the item. And then I'll have a second container with the selected item. And here I will have the description. There we go. Now let's turn this into a component. So on my tabs, let's make sure just my items are inside the tabs and my selected element are inside this tabs container. So I have this container, my tabs container, and I can either make it, transform it into a component here, or I can create a new component by clicking here. So let me call it tabs and create this as a component. Okay, so now I'm in a components view. If I go back to the instance, I see my layout, which is a blank section with my tabs component. Anything I add afterwards is outside the tabs component. If I want to go back inside the tabs component, I need to select it and start editing it. All right, so the first thing I want is to give users of the component the option to bind a collection to it. So here I will create a property called items, and it can be anything. And here I can add some help text, for example, bind to a list of items. In advance here, I just want to make sure that it is bindable so that the user can bind it. If I switch this to off and create, if I go back to my instance, I won't be able to bind the list of items. But if I go back to edit and switch bindable to on and save this, that back on my instance, the user can bind their list of items. So here I'm going to bind to my fruits collection. And then inside my component, I can refer to the component property. So here my text, for example, will be the name of the collection. And I can capitalize it to format it in a nice way. The list of items will be the data, my list of items in here inside the collection. So I can bind to the collection data, and then you see that these items, this text is repeated 3 times. So then I can bind to the current item, and I see apple, pear, banana. Let me just add a little row gap here so that it's nicer and you see the space between the list of items and then this selected item. All right, so now what we could do is we could say that when the user clicks on a text, it will update a variable inside our component. Let's call it selected item. It will be an object variable and we'll create it here. So you'll notice that here we have this data, this variable, but it's not available anywhere else in the project. And that's fine because we don't need it elsewhere in the project. We want to scope it inside the component. And we only need it there. So it's absolutely fine. And it keeps our global variables, our project variables, nice and clean. So now on the text element, I want to have a workflow that says on click, change the variable value, so a selected item, with the current item data. So now, if I clear this and I go to my variables, I see the variables from the component, the selected component. If I click on test, you see that it updates the variable with the banana information that I was on, because I was on the banana text when I created the workflow. So here, update selected item. There we go. And now because I have this information on my selected item description inside the component, I could bind the text to the variable, the component variable, and add the description. Now, if I go back to layout, let me go back to my instance and remove this heading. Now, if I go to preview mode, if I click on apple, pear, banana, the selected item is updated and the description is updated. And this is completely neutral for you using this component. All you have to do is pass the items. So if we duplicated the tabs or just added them from our project library, just add a new tabs here. Now I can bind to my treats collection and by default it will work. So spaghetti, bananas, cookies, all right. And now if I'm on the tabs component and I edit it, I can also edit information once. So for example, I could say, I could add the fruit, the little symbol here, and it will also update this and all the other instances of the component because I edited the component itself. And if I wanted to add a little bit of style, so for example, here the text, so on the items, I don't want to stretch this. I just want to align like this and the text, I want to keep like this. And when I also want an active state. So on the text, I can create a state that I will call active. And the condition will be if the ID of the context is equal to the ID of the selected item of my internal variable, that will mean it's an active state. And if the state is active, I want the background color to change. So maybe it will be a light pink. Now back to the instance. If I go to preview mode, you can see that banana is currently selected and cookies is currently selected. If I change this to spaghetti, bananas, the style changes and so on here. Now, if I wanted to, I could make a change on the instance of a component. So for example, I could decide that the width of that this component had a max width of 300 pixels. And this would only be applied to this instance and not that instance, because I made the change at instance level, not inside the component. Same if I wanted to change the background color. Let's say I want the background color to be blue or purple. Now I change this on the instance, so it's not reflected on the other instance of the component. But if I went and edited the component and changed the background color here to green, it would be reflected in this component. And if I added other instances of the component, so back on my layout, I could add other instances. And if I changed the background color here, it would change on all the instances except the ones where I overrid the setting on the instance by adding a background color, a different background color on the instance. That's it. That's how you can create a tabs component in WeWeb without writing code.